Today, any new person is playing on Vrindavan very well. Who is he? Why is he that Markandeya? Thank Markandeya. I want more association. You gave only one day. I want that you should give some more time to me. Like Pran Kishore and your other friends, Uddhav Prabhu and others. If you give more time, then you will gain more. Vaiban. Like then, you are all friends coming, so you should come. Your wife should also come and associate me. This world is related only for show. No real happiness. But obey Krishna, obey Swamiji, Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, and be happy. You cannot be happy in this world. You are coming in this world life for life, but no happiness. You cheated. Don't be cheated again. You, no more.
Yeah. Which is completely false, which is a road of thorns, but I was traveling on this thinking that this is the real enjoyment. Te karane lagi loje karma bandh phans. And because of misusing my own independence and enjoying the material world, what was the consequence, what was the result? The result was this endless chain of birth and death, the trap of the strong bondage of the karmic reactions have trapped me eternally in this material world. Vishaya vishama vish satat khayinu. And what I was doing, thinking it nectar, I was drinking the strong poison of this material enjoyment, sense enjoyment. Gaura kirtana rathe magana na huinu. And because of being intoxicated and completely overwhelmed from this poison, which is so dangerous that it just not only kills me once, but this poison of material sense enjoyment is killing life after life after life and dragging me or deviating me away from the real path. And because of that, I could not join or participate in Gaur Kirtan. The sadhus, they're always, the devotees of Lord Gaurhari, they are chanting his glories. And I missed that. I could never take part in that chanting, in that sadhu sangha. So realizing all these misfortunes and his degraded position, Srila Narottam Thakur now takes a deep breath and he says, "Ha! What's the use of my life? For what my life is still there? Why I'm sustaining my pran? Why my breathing is still going on? Why? Just for some material sense pleasure? Is that the goal of my life for which I have been given this human form of life?" So he is regretting and he is again and again condemning his wretched position, and in this way he is humbly trying to pray to receive the mercy of Sri Gaurachandra.
You should touch the meaning, deep meaning of this kirtan and compare with your life and then learn something. What is the essence of this kirtan? Narottam Thakur is but Bhavati, he is lamenting so much. Oh, what I am doing? I have lost my this human life. Krishna came himself in the form of Shashi Nandan. And Vaiji is the path he told by Sankirtan. In high association, can give you eternal happiness. But what we are doing opposite, you are not associating, we are associating, with great interest, with Mayavadi, with Sahajiya, with Vishayi. Sense enjoyers. And we are very far away from these things. What? High class of Jesus. They are happy enjoying this world. But what it is? Nothing, zero. अधने जतन करी धन त्यागिनु. Why you may come late, daily late? Don't make late. अधने जतन करी धन त्यागिनु. कृपाराम प्रभु, what is the meaning? अधने जतन करी धन त्यागिनु.
In this song, Narottamdas Thakur laments how we devote our energy and our time to the worthless efforts in this material world and neglect the real wealth that is coming in our Guru Parampara from Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in the form of the Harinam Sankirtan movement. While this process is so easy that anyone can perform it without any qualification, yet, and we have had the association and the contact with pure Vaishnavas, yet still we spend the majority of our time pursuing material objects, material sense gratification, and neglect this unique opportunity to end this material misery once and for all and obtain eternal happiness at the lotus feet of Sri Krishna.
We should know what is real wealth and what is poison. But we are thinking opposite. We are thinking poison to be wealth and wealth to be
poison.
Opposite. By taking poison we will die. We will be very suffering. We will suffer. What we are doing? We are like Vishai, most of us. Vishai. Sometimes we put tilak, sometimes we can teach Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. But we are very interested to, this worldly wealth. Money. We don't give more time in Krishna bhajan. Moment of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sankirtan. With love, which will give you eternal bliss and eternal happiness and real wealth. That is love of Krishna and Radha. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu started this moment for this, that I am explaining. The object of our life, it will be. But we have no faith at all. Sometimes I think that I should not come to Western or Eastern country. I should stop my preaching, traveling and preaching, and I should continue my Christian movement, Hare Krishna always. Because I'm saying that all are neglecting, very rare are taking serious. So I want to do it. But again I remember the words of my Gurudev and my subsectic line of gurus, Narottam Thakur, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Rupa Goswami Mahaprabhu. Again I come. Again I think that I will not come. Bhakti Vinod Thakur also. Why I am preaching this Nagar Sankirtan and Jharu Nam Bhatta. I should stop. But who could not stop? Because they were merciful. You know, for you all, your Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Swami Maharaj, how he was suffering? He suffered a lot till his life, end of his life. I think that he was given poison also, and so many things. So you should try to realize all these things and try to join Krishna Sankirtan of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Follow this path. Gaur Premanande. Name? Some new name? Dakshina of afterworld. After class. I should begin my class something. Because only today and tomorrow. Mirandhasy Gyanam Jana Shalakaya Chakshurun Vilitam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namah Vancha Kalpatarubhyasya Kripa Sindubhyayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Mahabadannaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gauratishe Gurave Gaurachandraya Radhikaya Tadale Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tadabhaktaya Bhaktya Vihinaya Aparadha Lakshay Shiptasya kamaditaranga madhye Kripamayin tvang saranam prapanna Vindenu maste charanarindam Yang praprajantam anupetam apeta krityam Dvaipayuno virahakatar yajuhava Putreti tanmaitayatar vobhinedu Tang sarvabhutaridayam munimanutoshi Tavai vasmi, tavai vasmi, najivami tvayabina, iti bhigyai radhe, tam naimam charanam tike. I have told so many things, explaining the object of our life. What should be our object? And I told that topmost prayojan is a love like gopis. This is the highest goal. And for this only highest goal, Krishna in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sachinandan Gaur Hari, he came. He traveled whole India, here and there. He sprinkled mercy even to mad elephants and tigers, bears and all. In Srimad Bhagavata it has been told, Prayena Alpa Aisha Sab अभ्य क्लास्मिन जुगे जना मंदास मंद मतो मंद भाग्या ही उपत्तुता. Also it has been told, लब्ध्वा सुदुर्लभमिदं बहु संभवन्ति मानुष्यम अर्थदम अनित्यम अपि हधीर तृणम जतेत न पतेत अनुमृत्युदाव निशेषाय विशाल सुखल सर्वतस्य. What Narottam Thakur has sung, or in this very slok is that, Labdhva Sudurlabham Vidam. By the causeless mercy of Krishna, we have received, he has managed to give a human form, intelligence, very beautifully strong body, like boat, very strong new boat. He is also merciful to give a very qualified, high class of guru. He sent on your door, to your door. Guru came to your door to help you. And also association, good association. Time to time he is giving. This is anukul, favorable wind. And having all these things that Krishna has given you, these favorable things, to be happy forever. And if you are not utilizing proper, then you are what? Self-killer.
Killer of the soul.
Killer of his own and others also, both. You are hearing, but not falling. Sometimes lust comes to you and covers you. Sometimes worldly desires comes to you and covers you. Some bad societies comes and you think that this is favorable. I think among all enemies, uncontrolled mind is our
biggest
enemy, and that you are falling. You cannot judge what is good and bad, and thus losing your whole life. Oh, Krishna was suffering much, a lot of suffering, and that is why he came to our door. In the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in the form of Nityananda Prabhu, he went door to door, oh, begging, what? Once he should tell Krishna, once even, Jathashtam re bhrata, kuru hari hari, dhanam manisham, tato vasansaram bodhitaran dayo mailage. I am responsible. You should chant once Krishna and you will be liberated and happy forever. And if not, then I am responsible for this. At least one time you should chant. I want this baby. Not money, no wealth, nothing. I want. But you refused. We are refusing. Sometimes giving what that I will, but never doing. If doing with so many desires, covered with so many things. So be careful. Our life, this life, very costly. But there are so many desires. So Srimad Bhagavatam, it has been told, Manda, Sumanda Matayo, Manda Bhagya, he upadvijat. What? Manda means?
Lazy.
Oh, what is the explanation? Manda, Sumanda Matayo.
Prayena Payusha Shabya Kalavasmin Yuge Janaha. Manda, Sumanda Matayo, Manda Bhagya Upadvijataha. In this iron age of Kali, men, they have but short lives. They are lazy, misguided, unlucky, and above all, their minds are always disturbed. So here this verse is explaining that in this age of Kali, that we have so much energy to pursue the objects of the senses, to enjoy different types of sense gratification. But when it comes time to take seriously to sadhana and bhajan, then we're very lazy. We're misguided. We're being misguided by our senses. We're being cheated by our mind. What to speak of so many charlatans in the form of spiritualists. Unlucky. Why? Because, as Gurudev has said, by Krishna's mercy, that sadhu guru is coming to our door. Not that we have to run to find, but sadhu is running to us and giving mercy, giving so much kripa. But how unfortunate we are that we cannot take. Very nice pastimes there in this regard. But we
cannot.
And the mind is always disturbed.
And manda bhagya, always suffering. Always suffering. They do everything to be happy, but not happy. Oh, they saw a very beautiful lady, very beautiful. They were attached so much. And she cheated, weeping bitterly. But yet, oh, we are pursuing another lady. She is kicking from behind. But yet, or like donkeys, we don't have any lesson from this. So in this sloka also it has been told. We hear and we are, but don't follow. This is the thing. So we should follow the process to have object. What object? Krishna prem. Like gopi prem. This is very costly. We'll have to give up everything for this. Oh, so many persons very eagerly came to me. I want to do bhajan. Please help me. Oh, I've come for this object, to help you. Oh, I want something in dakshina. You should give your hairs and I will give you Krishna prem. What? Oh, please. Not possible. I cannot give this. Even this scene, what are these? These are maila of, sorry.
Dirt
of our body. If you cannot give your hair even, and you want Krishna prem, what is this? You are cheating Krishna. You are cheating Gurudev. How it can be possible? You will have to give everything. It has been told. Krishna bhakti rasabhavita mati kriyatam kuto bijadi labhyate. Tatra laulyam api mulya veikalam. Koti janma sukritirna labhyate. Try to hear attentively, why here and there, what discussing now.
He said that we should not use flash.
Yes. Don't do. You should try to take my instruction. You are not taking instructions and that is why you want to take it. By this Krishna Prem will not come. But by artificial things, for showing. I want to take it. Don't advertise Krishna Prem. If you advertise, it will go like camphor. So you should be very careful for this. So if I tell, you should give your bad desires to me. Prabhu, I cannot do. But even I want Krishna prem. If bad desires are there, anartha are there, offensive things are there, how you can get it? Your Shraddha is not real Shraddha. What is Shraddha? Begin from Shraddha. And it will come from high class of association. Shraddha comes from hearing and hearing. If anyhow this rare Shraddha has come in your heart, but not Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha of Mayavadi, Dharmadhvaji. Dharmadhvaji, you know?
Imposters.
What meaning?
Cheaters in religion.
Only they tell, this is dharma, dharma, dharma. But not actually falling. If anyone is doing the association, coming in the enunciation of that class of person, how he can gain bhakti? He can never. If anyone has attained this Shraddha, even what is Shraddha? To serve Krishna. Desire to serve Krishna. Even it has come. But not associating with high class of devotee. Only karmi, vishayi, jnani and others. Like camphor, this also Shraddha will disappear at once. So be very careful. Anyhow, you are very lucky and fortunate to come in the association, hearing so much. So, Srimad Bhagavat and all Shastra are telling. So I began Bhajan Rahasyam in where? In India. Kartik or before Kartik, there in Puri,
Vrindavan,
Kartik month, Bhajan Rahasya. But only two chapters I could finish hardly. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is explaining, for Shraddha, anyhow it has come. But if you cannot maintain your Shraddha and it disappears, then you are losing everything. Why we are losing? Because we are not properly using our intelligence to remove our anarths. We should know our anartha, unwanted things, and try to get rid of these anarths very, very carefully. If you are chanting something, if you are hearing something, but not trying to get rid of these anarths, nama, prada and all other things, then your Shraddha will go, even it has come. So you should know what are anartha. And I have explained, and by email everywhere it has gone. I explained four kinds of anarths. Sarup Brahm, Asat Krishna, Hriday Dorvalya, and aparadh. Very dangerous these things. Sarup Brahm. Can you?
Sarup Brahm means illusions relating to spiritual life, and there are four different types of Brahms or illusions. One Brahm is the illusion about the nature of our own self. The illusions about the nature of our own self, such as that we think we're this body and this mind, or we may think that our soul was with Krishna and now has come into the material world. So many illusions are there. and also allusions about the nature of Bhagavan Paratattva Brahm, also Sadhan Sadhya Brahm, illusions about the nature of the goal, of the ultimate goal of life, and the process by which to reach it. And fourth one.
Oh, Mayata. Let him do. Molot.
Satatte paratatte cha.
Slok bolte hai mene. Hamne boli.
So, anarthas are, unwanted things are four types. Illusion are four types. Sarubhram.
What is Sarubhram?
Sarubhram means, who am I? And who is Krishna? And what is relation between myself and Krishna? I don't know. So it is called Sarubhram. Asat Krishna. All living entity, constitutionally they are eternal servant of Krishna. So our desire must be to serve Krishna. But other than Krishna, we are hankering for other things. It is called Asat Krishna. Hridaya Durbala.
Why it came?
Because we forget Krishna.
Because we now think that this body is myself. And the relative things are mine. And by this we can be happy. If we can collect anything for body, money, and other things, by this I will be happy. And if my relatives will be happy, I will be happy. Huh? We forget Krishna, and now we are doing this for them. Oh, this is Asat Krishna. Asat Krishna is bound to come. Then Asat Krishna. Then Hridaya Durbala, weakness of heart. We know we have heard from Guru and Vaishnavas. If we want to be eternal happy, then we have to surrender ourselves, the lotus feet of bona fide Gurudev, and have to maintain four regulative principles. We want that, but due to weakness of our heart, we could not maintain properly. Sometime we are maintaining, sometime we could not do so, due to our weakness of our heart. When weakness of heart is there, then offense bound to come. So the offense also so many types, like seva aparad, nama aparad, dhamma aparad, etc. So unless until we not surrender completely in the lotus feet of bona fide Gurudev, and not always being in bona fide association, we are not able to get rid of all these things. So we have to be in always good association and surrender ourselves the lotus feet of bona fide Gurudev. And by his instruction, if we continue our practices, then we can overcome for all these things. Then we will be eternal happy and we can realize our own sarup, and then we can serve divine couple. What is Hridaya Durbala? We should try to know. Hridaya Durbala means weakness of heart. How? When we knew that, oh, this body is myself, dehatma buddhi. And then it came that, oh, they are my relatives, they are my friends. No? It came. But anyhow, your friends are if, oh, maha vishai.
Sense enjoyers.
Even they worship for sense enjoyer, to enjoy senses. Whatever they do for enjoy. If anyone has friend, bosom friend, and anyhow become Mayavadi or atheist, but even he comes to our door in our house, we respect him. Because his friend, our friend tells that, I want to be in your house for some days. at least 1 week. He became very happy, gave shelter, and discussing only what? Atheist things. And the effect came. Effect is bound to come. And he lost his faith, desire to serve Krishna. What happened? This is weakness. Relation, worldly relations makes us weak. Oh, any friend came. Oh, friend. Oh, take one glass of wine. No harm. No harm. I take daily. I feel so much happy. Oh, I have left it. Oh, no harm. For one day you should take. Oh, yes, you are telling, requesting. So I... Oh, and he took. This is weakness. You tried very hard to not become lusty. Very beautiful girl came. Oh, I love you. Oh, I don't like. But I love you. I love you. I want to serve you, to please you. I love you. Oh, no cause. What? Causeless love I have. I only want to serve you because I love you. Oh, she is telling again. Oh, I kissed. Though I am renounced. And after that, you know, Maya came. Oh, this is weakness, heart weakness. And by this what came? Oh, Mahaparat. You are bound to do offenses to your Gurudev because you are disobeying him. He has told you not to do all these things, but you are offending. You are doing so many things against Krishna and devotees. You cannot check yourself. Thus, involving in this world. So first try to obey Vaishnavas, like Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Narottam Thakur has told. Srila Rupa Goswami, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur has told. Srila Sanatana Goswami has told. He is like what? Endless merciful. Causeless merciful. Vairagya yoga bhakti rasam apayan manu bhikshu mandam kripam bodhir ja para dukkha dukhi sanatanastam ashraya. So you should follow all these things and be happy. So you should be very careful not to mix with mayavadi, vishayi, dharma bhajya and all others and try to give up all your weakness of hearts, anartha, unwanted things, aparadha and all other things, gradually. And chant Harinam. You will see, oh, very soon Krishna prema will come. At least, oh, taste will come. Then asakti may come, very soon. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur has told, in second adhyaya, oh, bhaktutani nahi. So, it has been told everywhere like this. Also it has been told. Satang prasangam mama virja sambhido bhavantarita karnara sayana katha tajyo sanataya su apabhargvavartmani sadharati bhakti anukramishyati. Like this. Oh, satang prasangam mama virja sambhido. Always be in high class of Santa, who have engaged their everything, whole senses and everything, falling uttama bhakti. And discussing what? Oh, powerful, sweet pastimes of Krishna always. And it is coming like tasmin mahan makhritang madhuvaisharitra. Madhuvid, cutting, who cuts the worldly sweetness attachment. And who is he? Krishna is he. Madhuvisharita, very powerful. His all pastimes are very powerful. So always discussing these things, like Rupa and Sanatana. Giving one piala to cup to Sanatana and Sanatana giving one cup to. They are mad in Harikatha. Like Mahaprabhu and Swarup Damodar Raya Ramananda. Sitting, whole night, went in a second, weeping and weeping bitterly. You know? So this should be like that. Prasatam prasangam virja sambhidau bhavante rit karunar shayana katha. So much sweet things comes in that prasanga of Krishna. He killed Putana. He killed Agasur, Bakasur and all. He was playing in the new forests of Vrindavan with cowherd boys. Why he was cowherding? Because there he can freely meet his friends gopis. To give chance and to rally high class of Russia to take a bath in that. So these sweet pastimes. I think that Mahaprabhu was 24 years in cave discussing day and night, weeping, sometimes jumping in ocean, sometimes here and there. You know all these things. But this sweet pastime is very powerful. And by hearing this, anyone can be like Raghunath Das Goswami. He drank that rush, one drop from the mouth of Swarup Damodar and second cup from the mouth of Rupa and Sanatana. And he became totally mad. If you want to be like that, oh, hear Harikatha. This is the mercy of a sant, really. You cannot please by worldly flowers, worldly what? Gifts, presentation, clothes, sweets, and other presents. If you can give pure heart and your dear, this, yes. Oh. He wants only that you should give him. Oh, your ears. He can make it pure and he can give that ocean, drop of ocean, bhakti ras in ears. You should prepare. Satang prasangam varja sambhijau bhavantarit karana rasayana katha tajosanath asu apabargulatmani. If you will drink one drop of that, then apabarga vartmani, this will give you to be in the line, in the marga of, in the way of apabarga. What apabarga? All the barks were gone. Apabarga. Apagata, barga. Barga means artha dham kaam. And moksha, these bargas. They are bound to go. And then what will come? Oh, very soon, Vaikunth will come. And you will pass. Then Ajodhya will come. You will pass. Not seeing here and there. And then you will pass. And will reach very soon to Dwarka, Golok. And Dwarka. And you will, 1.8. And you left, you give up Dwarka, and Mathura will come, you will do pranam, you will take bath in Vishram Ghat. Oh my all, unwanted thing, you should take vishram here, I am. Let me go to Vrindavan. In this way. And then you should go to Keshi Ghat. And then taking bath and take the darshan of Govindadev with Radhika there. So, Apavargvartani, first Shraddha will come to desires, to serve Krishna will come, association will come, and the sadhana bhakti will come of Uttama bhakti, and this after that Bhav bhakti will come, and then Prem bhakti. So, you should try to follow all these things. I think that I wanted to tell so many things, but in a moment our time passed. Now it is 7. There is also drama play. I think that you should play all drama with me of this, and you should drink of that nectar of Harikatha and follow me. Don't cheat me. Don't cheat me. You should give me words like Nityananda Prabhu wanted. This will be the highest gift that we will do bhajan. We'll follow totally as you are telling. You should know that I'm telling same thing. Oh, like your Gurudev, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami. I'm telling same thing, like Rupa Goswami. I'm not qualified like them, but even I'm like a letter distributor, by like postman. I'm coming to you, door to door. You should give me this gift, that you will chant and you should be like that. Never be weak. Don't be weak. Always more than thunderbolt. Don't associate with bad element, Vishayi, Jnani, Karmi and others. And thus you should be in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Kirtan movement and be successful in your life. Gaur Premananda.
Hare Krishna. So Dhamma players will be ready for the performances. Before that, who has taken Diksha and they sit in fire sacrifice and wait for Diksha, they can come and offer to their Diksha to Gurudev now.
Oh, you do any kirtan?
Tomorrow afternoon there will be no darshan. Gurudev will come for class early because we have to travel the next morning very early.
Radhe Jai Jai Madhava.
5 o'clock, class will start tomorrow. 5 o'clock. Afternoon.
Key.
Anyone who is going to Los Angeles this evening or tomorrow morning, please contact me. We need one devotee.
Give a line to come here, Dakshina.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. If any devotees are going to Los Angeles tonight or tomorrow morning early, please contact me.
The immediate associates of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Can someone get a pinnacle devotion from the paper? Gaur Vastakam are written to glorify the spiritual masters, and the Sat Goswami Astakam are written to glorify the 6 Goswamis of Vrindavan. We only chanted the first 2 before we start class because we're going to be discussing the book of Srila Rupa Goswami. I'd like to read the translation of those 2 slokas. 105. I worship the 6 Goswamis, Sri Rupa Sanatan Raghunath Bhatta, Raghunath Das, Sri Jiva, and Gopal Bhatta, who are always engaged in singing Krishna's name, beauty, qualities, pastimes, and dancing in the mood of the sweetness of his leelas. The Goswamis are the very embodiment of the ocean of the nectar of divine love, Premamrita Samudra Swarupa. They are accepted and respected by learned and ignorant persons alike, and their activities endear them to all because they hold no envy toward anyone. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has fully blessed them with his mercy. Thus they are able to spread the sweet nectar of bhakti, thereby diminishing the burden of sinful life on the earth. I offer prayers to the six Goswamis who are so expert in extracting the essence of all the revealed scriptures, with the aim of establishing the jiva in his eternal supreme position, of performing pure devotion, Sudha Bhakti Rupa Parama Dhamma. Their activities bring auspiciousness and a supreme benefit to all. Thus they are worshipped in all the three worlds. They are especially affectionate to those who take shelter of them, and they are so much absorbed in their service to Sri Sri Radha Govinda that they have become mad like bees intoxicated by the honey of their lotus feet. In another translation of the same sloka, it says, I offer my prayers to the six Goswamis, who are expert in scrutinizing and studying the revealed scriptures for the benefit of all human beings. So both translations are very nice. I believe Shamarani Didi has been discussing the verse from the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, which Gurudev has also mentioned.